Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this tutorial, we are going to see how to build a data table in React application using React Table. Before jumping into the tutorial, let's have a quick demo of what we are going to build in this tutorial. So here we have the data table, which is like, as of now, we are only having the columns. So the row will be added dynamically. So each row is going to be an editable cell, so we can able to fill up the data. Once we fill up the data, we can able to save the data in the Google Sheet. So if we go to the sheet, we can able to see the saved data here. So if you want to learn how to integrate Google Sheet in Node.js application, I have already uploaded a tutorial for it. I will leave the link in the description below. So please go and check it out as well. Also, we can able to filter the particular data table using the particular input here. So let's filter out using the email here. So as you can see, we can able to also filter using the input. At the same time, we can able to filter through the drop down here. So here are the functionality that we are going to build for this data table using React Table. Now we have a basic setup for our React application by running the create React app scaffold, along with we have also set up the Tailwind CSS in our React.js application. So I recommend you to check out this article of explaining how to set up the Tailwind CSS in your React.js project. So let's start implementing the data table in our React application. So for that, we are going to use a library called React Table. Let's install the React Table in our application. Now we have installed the React Table in our application. Let's quickly go to the React Table documentation and see how to get started quickly. So as you can see that we have installed the React Table to get started quickly. So these are all the main concepts in React Table. So before diving into the documentation of this page, let me quickly walk you through the basics of React Table. So mainly the React Table contains a React hooks called useTable, which will take the columns and data. So the columns are going to be what we have seen in our demo. So the columns is going to be the top thing, and the data is going to be the rows that we are going to insert into. Let's quickly create a React component, which is going to be the React data table. Let's create it as a table, and set up a basic boilerplate for a React functional component. So now we have the basic React functional component. Let's import our React table here. From here, we need the hooks called useTable. So now we got the useTable React hook. So we just need to use it, hook it inside our functional component. So it's going to take two parameters. Those are will be the columns and the rows. The rows will be represented as data here. So we just need to pass the columns and data into the props of this particular component. use table is going to return some of the properties that we need to use inside our DOM element. Let's quickly import all the properties and insert them into our DOM element here. So some of the important properties are table and table body, and then header groups and rows. Here we have table prop, header groups and rows. Let's import those properties inside our HTML DOM element. Header groups properties is gonna return as the columns that we have defined in our table component. So we just need to loop through the header groups to get all the columns from there and render it inside our thead DOM element. So we will render the table row inside it, map the property for the table row here. Inside our header group, it's gonna be the table heading. So we just need to loop through it to get all the headers from the column. So we can get the column here. Inside the column, you will render the table heading with the specified name. We just need to map the functionality inside our table heading DOM element. So far we have completed the column rendering. We just need to complete the rest of table body, just like how we have done the table header here. Let's quickly map get table body props. It's gonna be table body props. Then we just need to loop through the rows to get all the data and render it inside the table row. To simplify this one, I'm just going to copy paste the code here. Now we got the complete working model for the table component. Let's try to import this into our parent component and pass the data, column data as well as the row data into this and render the table in the web page.